Hey guys, this is version 2 of my Steadicam. I've gotten some requests for a step-by-step build, so that's what we're going to do right now.
We're going to start with the main frame, which is arguably the hardest part to build. Even so, it's not that difficult. It's made out of aluminum bar that is 1.25 inches wide and 1/8 inch thick. The bar I bought from Lowe's, and it comes 3 feet long. You probably can find a similar piece of metal at Home Depot or other hardware stores. It comes silver. It's painted black with Plasti-Dip. It's kind of a rubber coating that you can take off if you want, but it kind of has a soft touch to it and makes the whole rig look more professional. The top platform here, that's where the camera's mounted and the grip mounts to. It is 4.75 inches long. There's a bend right here, so this part is 4.75 inches long. The back weight is, that hole is about 1/2 inch from the back of the platform. The camera hole right here is about 1.3 inches, 1.25 inches, 1.3 from the weight hole. And then we've got the grip mounting hole here is about 2 inches from the camera hole, and those are the center of the hole is about 2 inches. It's difficult to measure to the rest of the Steadicam because it's curved. It's roughly 15 inches from the bend at the top to the very end down here. It's about 15 inches. Right around the 11 inch mark is where it starts getting straight again. So from the platform to the 11 inch mark is curved. I curve that around a air tank cylinder. You just want it, when you curve it, you want that to be a straight bend so that this part will be directly underneath the platform. If it's bent off center, then the balancing is going to be very difficult. So you want to make sure this bend is straight. Get something that you can bend it around and it'll be a nice smooth bend. Just take your time doing that and just check your progress often. The aluminum is fairly bendable, so it's not hard to do. You can pretty much bend it by hand. The air tank that I used to bend this around, it was about 9 inches in diameter, just so you know for reference. It's a fairly large bend, so it was about 9 inches. Another thing that I did when I built my Steadicams is leave the tail down here long when you're first starting off. Once you get it all assembled, then you can determine where you want to drill this bottom hole so that it's directly under your grip. That's where you want it. So you leave this inch or two long just to make sure that you've got enough metal to work with, and then you can go back later and cut it off. The front weight is basically in the very front of the Steadicam, kind of in a horizontal on a horizontal plane. It is about, let's see, it's about 8.5 inches up from the bottom weight. That is, let's see, roughly 7 inches from the bend on the platform. The weights that I use on my Steadicams are just fender washers. I don't know the technical size for them, but they're about 1.25 inches in diameter. On mine, I've got 10 in the back, 4 in the front, and 4 in the bottom. And yours might be slightly different depending on the dimensions of your frame and how you have everything mounted. I'm just using bolts and nuts to secure them. They are nylock nuts, so they're not going to come loose on you. But anyway, I assembled them all together and then sprayed them with the Plasti-Dip, and it makes it look good. Okay, now that we've got the frame pretty well built, I want to talk about the main joint for the Steadicam. This is built from Traxxas brand remote control vehicle U-joints. This part is called a stub axle, this half. And this part of it is called a half shaft. This is built out of two Traxxas part numbers. The joint is made from a stub axle for a T-Max 2.5. This is Traxxas part number 4953X. And a short half shaft from a T-Max 2.5. And that is Traxxas part number 4949X. The short half shaft comes with the ball that's actually the joint in there. So when you buy these, you'll get two stub axles and I think two or four short half shafts. It's two little packages. And you take them and assemble them this way. They may be stiff when you put them together. You want this to be loose, but not extremely sloppy. So you may have to ream out the holes for these pins so that the pins can move freely in the holes. Just be careful because this plastic is very soft and it's easy to make the holes too big. From here, you need your bearings that will go on the shaft and that attaches to the grip in a second. These are 6x22x7 ball bearings. They fit on the shaft really well, nice and tightly, no slop. And the outside will fit in the grip really well. You do have to put a little bit of clear packing tape on there, possibly, but that just makes it real tight. After you put one bearing on the shaft, I use just a spare nut that I had laying around. It's just a spacer. It doesn't thread on, but it's just a spacer. And then another little washer fits on, again, just as a spacer. And then the second bearing. After that, you need a nut. This is another Nylock nut. This is actually probably a Traxxas part, but you could probably find it at a hardware store. I think Traxxas calls it a flanged nylon locking nut, part number 5147X, but it's really just a nut that fits these threads. And just screw that on and tighten it down. So once you get that tight, then you've got no slop on here, but the bearings can spin freely and nice and smooth, and that's kind of the joint there. Okay, now that we've got the joint together, we need to assemble the grip. This is 3/4 inch CPVC. It's not PVC, it's CPVC. It usually has a slightly brown or yellowish tint to it. The reason we're using that is because it fits our bicycle grip perfectly. This is just a 3/4 inch female-female adapter. It's sprayed with black Plasti Dip. That's why it's black. On my particular Steadicam, this tube is about 4 3/8 inch long. You just assemble them together. I don't glue them or anything. There's no real need to. Just push that in there. And then you take your joint assembly and just stick it in, and with the packing tape, a couple layers on there, whatever you end up needing, it's very secure after that. So there's the grip. After that, you need your bicycle grip. This is one that I had laying around already. I've cut it down for my particular use. It's about a little less than 4 3/4. And you can get bicycle grips really cheaply. Foam or whatever should be very inexpensive. And this just slides right on. And that's the grip. One other thing that I forgot to mention is I just finished it off with a grip cap. I had these, and so you can just stick the grip cap in there and it just kind of makes it a little more finished off. It's not anything that you really need, but just makes it look a little bit better. So now that we've got the grip and joint assembled, we really need to attach that to the frame. What I use is a 5/16-18 by 1 inch long bolt. So the threaded portion is 1 inch long and the thread is 5/16-18. That's really just a bolt that I had laying around, but it fits in the end of the short half shaft pretty easily. This is not threaded from the factory, but if you go slow and gently, it will thread in, and it once you get it in there, it's a pretty tight fit, so it's secure. So just stick the bolt through your front hole and just thread it on. Towards the end of the thread, it will probably get pretty tight, and that's a good thing because then it won't come out when you're using it. It stays tight. And there you go, tightened together, and that's the general setup of the Steadicam. Now we just need to be concerned with mounting the camera. To mount the camera, we're going to use GoPro's tripod adapter. These are fairly easy to find, not too expensive. They are threaded with a 1/4-20 threaded bolt. That's what goes in there. The threads on this particular one that I have it's very short. It's about a little more than 1/4 inch, 3/8 maybe, something like that for the threaded length. You just need something that'll go through and tighten down. From there, you need 2 short arms from GoPro. You may be able to get away with a short and a long if you don't have 2 shorts, but this is just what I use. And we got 2 short knobs. So you just assemble them. Fairly standard. When you put these together, you want one of these side knobs to be on the right side, and then when you mount the camera out here, you want that knob to be on the left side to counteract the balance. So one knob on one side, one on the other. When you're assembling this, you really want your camera directly above the pivot point on the Steadicam. That just helps with balance. I like to use the frame when I mount it out here. It just gives great sound, and it looks good. It's easy to use, and it's lighter than the waterproof cases. I think that's about it for the build. Fairly straightforward. If you have any questions, definitely let me know. I'd be happy to answer them. I appreciate you guys watching and asking me things. So, thanks for watching.